M&A is more like marriage between the companies. Merger and acquisition means two companies combine the one company. The main purpose is to grow the company. In Malaysia, economy is very stable, the infrastructure is well organized, accounting and legal matters is also very, transparency is very clear. One case in Malaysia, the seller side is a manufacturer in Malaysia, and the reason why that they want to sell the company, succession issues, and also they want to expand the business, not only Malaysia, but also the global area. The buyer side was interested in this company because of the well-established equipment factory. So the Japanese company acquired this company. And after the acquisition, the Japanese company tried to provide much capital and human resource, and also the Japanese standard quality control system and the new technical perspectives. And then after 1 or 2 years, the sales and the profit more than 150% increase. So both sides are very happy now. In Japan, the number of M&A deals per year is around 4,000 now. But on the other hand, in Malaysian market, I think the less than 500. The merger acquisition between the same industries companies, but actually the more than 50%. It is more like the M&A between the other industries companies. So such as the manufacturer acquired by trading company, because the buyer side purpose is more like business diversification in terms of the geographical and the business expansion. So it's more being very diversified comparing the last few years. If the owner wants to sell the company, I think it's better to have a specific growth strategy to see the proper M&A procedure, and then also the how to find the buyer or seller properly. We have many sectors looking for. Please come to the seminar on 18th October, and we will mention about which sector we are looking for and what kind of company we are targeting. Now, they always say the 1 plus 1 equals 2. Try to make 1 plus 1 equals not 2. It's gonna be 3 through the acquisition or mergers.